brought suit, people would remember not that she'd won, but that she'd been suspected of shady dealings with a wealthy client. With Olney suing, no businesses or reputations would be at stake, only the authenticity of the picture itself.
Oh, I know why they call you a genius.
Oh, cool. Mason?
Yes?
My name's Colin Durant.
Well, how you do?
Just sit still. I just want to say one thing. Mason, you're not going to get away with what you're trying to do to me.
Just what is it you think I'm trying to do to you, Mr. Durant?
Don't play innocent. You know what I'm talking about. The damage suit you persuaded Otto only to bring against me. I suppose you thought that was a real bright little stunt.
I don't believe I like your choice of words.
I don't like your choice of methods. Cooking up that affidavit for Maxine Lindsay to sign. Don't try to squirm out of it, my shyster friend, because I know that's what you did.
Barry, let me take care of this.
Sit down. Just what are you trying to accomplish, Mr. Durant?
I'm just putting myself on record. I was on Olney's yacht with Maxine Lindsay, and I did look at the Gauguin, but I made no comments on its authenticity. I did say, before I'd certify it, I'd want to run some tests on it. If you and your cheap little gold-digging friend think you can parlay that into a Christmas basket of free publicity and cash at my expense, you've got a surprise coming.
That's all?
Yeah. That's all.
Why don't you let him have it, Barry?
Paul, did you tell anyone we were eating here?
No.
Tell him?
How could I? We didn't phone for the reservations until we left the yacht.
How do you suppose Durant found us?
He must have followed you.
Which means this was all an act, something deliberately staged. Paul, do you have Maxine Lindsay's telephone number?
Sure.
Genius, huh? Della, I think I've just been tagged as the world.